Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. In reacting to the release of Abijesha, the popular comedian princess took to Instagram to react after the actor Abijesha was granted bail on health grounds. And Abijesha lawyer said the actor was granted bail and will be released after his bail condition has been perfected. And we'll record that Abijesha, whose real name is Olanrewaju James Ominta, was caught on CCTV sexually molesting prisoner's underage foster daughter and was detained as a result. And reacting to the news he's been granted bail, Princess tweeted, "I will win, not immediately, but definitely." And she also added the hashtag, "God does not sleep," hashtag, "God loves children," hashtag, "Say no to child defilement," hashtag, "Say no to rape," hashtag, "Say something if you see something." And reacting to that, the lawyer of the said actor, Ominka James, which we know as Babaejesha, who is Adesina Ademola Ogunlanu, who happens to be the counsel to embattled actor Olanrewaju James, has thrown more light into how the actor accused of defiling the 14-year-old foster daughter of comedian Princess and was granted bail by a magistrate. In a video posted online, Ogunlanu said that their client has been in detention for more than 30 days and has been granted bail on at the facility of his detention. The magistrate that granted him bail is Chief Magistrate Toyin of the Lagos State Judiciary, and the Chief Magistrate, in partnership with the Ministry of Justice, in partnership with a private organization, Police Decongestion Scheme, led by a former chairman of the NBA in Ikorodu, Bayo Akinlade, visited Kwanti and under the Decongestion Scheme, visited that facility and met Abijesha. Something was curious there. His name was not even entered, as very much reliably lent. The chief magistrate, being bold and experienced, demanded to see him, and he was brought to see the team. He came towards them limping, and as we have described before, he was emaciated, and bail was granted to him summarily by the chief magistrate, and this is very, very commendable. Ogunlanu said the bail was granted essentially on health grounds and that the magistrate said the offense is bailable. The conditions of bail are that Babaejesha must have two sureties. One of the sureties must be a level 10 officer, a civil servant. The other one should be a blood relation of the thespian. The bail is put at 500,000 in large sum. It's not security. It is just a bond that if he should run away, the shorties will pay that. We are very sure it would not run away. The verification is to be done by the OC Legal of the SCID, Fancy. Speaking further, Ogunlanu said, "This is very good news as it is a victory for everyone." He said, "It is not a victory for Babaejesha alone, it is for everybody. Rights must be respected, laws must be respected. The idea of mob lynching, the idea of lopsided action when it comes to rights and privileges of fellow citizens should be described. I want to appreciate Chief Magistrate Toyin for the courage, for doing the right thing, for stepping into this matter. You remember the police had pondered to public opinion of some activists who were saying it should never be released and hung it on the neck of Jusin Strike, that they would have charged the man to court, and we're even talking about the Attorney General of Lagos State, which, with due respect to him, I wonder in the history of defilement, how can somebody who is not biased, who is not malicious, say a prima facie cases of defilement has been disclosed upon the facts of this case. We will look into that and take that up. The Babaejesha's right has been brazenly brutalized," he said. He also went further and says, "As far as we are concerned, both the police and the Ministry of Justice are to be indicted for the unnecessary brutalization of Babaejesha's rights. If a person is entitled, you give him his entitlement."
But maybe about 2 hours ago, he picked and explained to me that he's been very busy, that a meeting with the Commissioner of Police, Lagos State, and all that, and that maybe later in the evening, he will surely call me back. And this is very good news for us, and it is not a victory for even Baba Geshai himself alone. It's for everybody. Everybody. What rights must be respected, laws must be respected. The idea of mob lynching, the idea of lopsided action when it comes to rights and privileges of fellow citizens should be decried. I want to, on behalf of all the council in this matter, appreciate Chief Magistrate Tony Ogre for the candor, for the courage, for doing the right thing, for stepping to this matter. You remember the police had pandered to public opinion of some activists who were saying that it should never be released and all that, and hang it on the neck of Jews on strike, that they will have done the thing, the charge the man to court and all that. And they were even talking about the Attorney General of Lagos State, which with due respect to the Attorney General of Lagos State, that I wonder, even this sort of defilement, how could somebody who is not biased, who is not malicious, how can that person, and I'm talking straight to the Attorney General of Lagos State, Moyosori Onigbanjo, he's a fine gentleman, learned gentleman, a senior advocate of Nigeria, but he, for goodness sake, how could anybody say that a prima facie case of defilement has been disclosed upon the facts of this case? We'll look into that and take that to, because this gentleman, I'm talking of Omiyinka, Baba Gesha, his rights have been brazenly brutal. And like I said earlier, we are not begging for his release. We are not pleading for his release, because this is Nigeria. After this has happened, it is possible that some other poor people will still be pandering to some sinister forces and may give you one reason or the other. These shorties will surely be produced, and the verification must be done as speedily. No need, no time for food dragging. I reported to Nigerians last week that we met him limping. The same thing the magistrate that came on his surprise visit met. So I will have to salute the team. I will have to salute the Chief Magistrate Ogre. They fulfilled the wisdom of those saying that if mountain will not come, if Muhammad will not go to the mountain, then the mountain itself will go to Muhammad. They moved the mountain of justice to that panty, to that very horrible place where you see the road and enter into the bush. As far as we are concerned, both the police and the Minister of Justice are to be indicted for this quite unnecessary brutalization and oppression of Baba Geshe's rights. If a person is entitled, if he's entitled, you give him his entitlement. You don't need to say it has confirmed with your idea of morality or no morality. When you know the right thing to do and you refuse to do it according to the Bible, that's a sin unto you. I seriously, the Radical Agenda Movement in the Nigerian MB, Nigeria Bar Association, Ramimba, seriously frown what has happened to this gentleman, and that we are saying that we will not accept any idea of food dragging on this issue. The shortages will be produced by tomorrow. Efforts will be made to ensure that it is done. I want to thank everybody for standing with us on this quest and for not succumbing to blackmail. Once again, kudos to the Chief Magistrate Ogre team. Now the ball is in the court of the police now. Let's see whether we are going to see any pambola mbola.